Okay, science program. I've got mail, got my knife. What else? Oh! I almost made a major mistake there. So from the beer cupboard today, we have Whistler Brewing Black Tusk Ale. Sounds interesting. What do we know about this? Named for the jet black core of an extinct volcano, this dark English style ale erupts with chocolate and roasted coffee tones, mild bitterness, and a clean finish. Sounds good. Yep, I can definitely drink that. First thing is one module and plastic sheet. A two pack. That's good. Oh, that's more than... Okay. So first in, we have a set of these cutters. These are, I think, the same as those ones, model 170. Yeah, they are. Just got another set because these ones I've noticed that are starting to not quite meet. They're supposed to meet like that. They're starting to meet just slightly off. They're still cutting fine unless I'm doing really, really tiny stuff. Let's see how they compare with these ones. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Durable electrical wire cutter cable cutting pliers side snips flush pliers from GC Supermarket. I paid $2.59 with free shipping. That was just a regular purchase, not an auction. I just decided the other ones are starting to get beat up. And they lasted fairly well. And I abused them and they just kept going. So... what the hell? For $2, $2.50, I'll order another pair. So also in that same package, there is these two tubes of ICs, which I'm guessing are probably the same thing. And I can't see what they are. Ah, they're 555s. Okay. Those are always handy to have around. 20 pieces NE555 Dip 8 timers, new good quality, again from GC Supermarket because it was in the same package. $1.32 or 99 American pennies, free shipping of course. I just bought these for stock. They're just standard 555s, nothing magical about them. Just always a handy chip to have around. What's next? Lamp 01 Green. Okay, I think I nicked it. I did. Damn it. Sharp knife, though. Oh, it's a little bendable LED, presumably. USB light. It's a kind of a soft glow to it. Does it look like there should be something on the back side of that? Nothing in the package. It's got a little metal backing there. That's interesting. So, what do you have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 LEDs in there. These two on this end are a little bit dimmer. Don't know whether you can see that or not. Kind of soft white. I don't know what they're... They don't really look like they're warm white or cool white. They look somewhere in between. Oh, does that want to pop off? Oh, hello. Okay, now they look a bit warmer. Or a bit cooler, rather. What's going on in here? So each one's got a 51 ohm resistor by the looks of it. Okay, so that's fairly straightforward, just 5 volts, kind of a parallel bus. All right, nothing too surprising about that. I suppose it would be negligent of me not to check the power on this thing, and it seems to be drawing about 90 to 100 milliamps. Okay. Flexible USB LED light lamp. Portable bright USB LED lights for powerbank PC. Got this one from Ding Juan something. Currently he's got a few on auction. He's also got this one on buy it now for $1.32. I got it at auction for 53 cents, and he's got some. That seems to be something that this guy does quite often, is have this one on auction. Lots of people do, actually. And it's just a little reading light. Different colors available. 5 volts and claims to be 1.2 watts. So it should last for quite a long time on a power bank. So let's see if they're lying. Let's go with, well, yeah, 11 or 110 milliamps is kind of the highest that it's going there. So 0.11 amps. To get power, we need that times volts, which is showing as 4.7 right now, times 4.7 equals half a watt. And what did it say on the listing? It said 1.2 watts. That way you can't win them all. But actually, for this application, that's probably not a bad thing because it'll last forever on one of these little power banks. Next in is 10 SOT 89 DIP SO. Huh. DIP sockets? That doesn't look like DIP sockets to me. Oh, what's that? Okay, that's sockets. So that's what it says was in there. Let's take a look at it first. That is these DIP to SOT adapters in two different sizes. So you can mount these little SOT packages on there. These are 5-volt regulators, 1117s. And then the smaller packages can go on this side. And you just put some header pins in there and you can plug them into a breadboard or onto a standard standard circuit board that would take a larger through-hole package. Handy. 10 pieces double-sided SMD SOT223 to DIP SIP3 adapter PCB board DIY converter or various similar search terms. I got this for 99 cents Canadian from this guy, Technology Dash On Sale. He sells some other similar things right now, but not this exact one. So I will link you to a search that finds them. And the other thing in this package from the same seller is a set of 4 ceramic alignment tools. So we have, you know, that one looks like a little Phillips. That one is a little straight blade. That one is a little straight blade. And that one is a little, littler straight blade. So we have a size 15, 20, and 25. Does it say here? Yes, it does. So size 15 is 1.3 by 0.4 millimeters. Size 20 is 1.8 by 0.4 millimeters. And 25 is 2.6 by 0.4 millimeters. And then the Phillipsy one is just a number 0 Phillips. Okay. That's nice. So the reason that I would want, let's zoom out a little bit here. The reason I would want ceramic tipped screwdrivers obviously is not for durability. These are not pry bars. That's what the cheap dollar store stuff is for. These are because they're non-metallic, non-conductive. So when you're adjusting a potentiometer on a very high frequency circuit, possibly like this cheap metal detector, then you can get in here with your tool and adjust it without the tool itself influencing the circuit. This is a bad example because this is a crappy little kit, but anything that gets into higher frequencies and plays with inductance on the board, if you're trying to adjust it precisely, not having your tools influence what's going on is important. DIY adjust anti-static screwdriver plastic ceramic laptop repair home TO, I guess that's him, from Technology On Sale, same as the last one. This is the 4-in-1 lot. Looks like it's currently on sale for $5.16. Back when I bought it, it was on sale, I think, or just for sale for $4.68 Canadian, which was good, and I didn't pay any shipping. It's now got 40 cents shipping on it. Still, that's not a bad deal. It's also got them in individuals for about $2 each, give or take. But yeah, I got the 4-pack, and there's the 4 sizes. A lot easier to see than what I was showing you before. made of precision zirconium oxide. The hardness is super strong, not easy wear, high insulation, no sense, no magnetic, high, suitable for high frequency circuit adjustment. That's what I got them for. What is next here? Expansion board module and expansion board module and speaker module. Lots of stuff in there. Let's try not to cut it, shall we? Come out! Ah, something sticky. I don't like that. And smelly, too. Okay, we have a module in there. We have a tube of something that the label's falling off. And, oh, I know what this one is. This is the UV curing glue, which has leaked. And has a little UV light on the cap of it. Which... ah, yuck. I'm going to leave that in the bag. Yish. I'm going to go wash my hands and then I'll check on the computer. Julian Eilets used this stuff and he actually uses it as a conformal coating. But it seems to dry pretty hard. So if I can shine some UV on it, I should be able to just harden up the goo that's on the outside of it, shouldn't I? Yeah, that's a good idea. Fix UV light repair tool, quick 5 second glue refill liquid plastic welding set from CZB 672-1960. I bought a bunch of stuff from them before. There's no way I paid $25 shipping. Obviously, you know who you're dealing with here, right? I paid $1.86 Canadian, which works out to $1.40 American for the pen plus glue. They also have just the pen. Oh, wait a minute. That's probably what I bought. The pen. Okay. So pen plus glue has refills, I guess. And then you can just buy the refill as well. Super powerful liquid plastic welding compound. Dries clear. Not glue. Super powered liquid plastic welding compound. Cures with UV. No battery included. Okay. So I'll have to do something else then to cure this stuff. Fortunately, I have some UV LEDs. So I'll just put them in my LED tester and harden this thing up so that I can at least touch it without my fingers getting all goopy. I figured I'd look at what else I ordered from these guys in that package, especially since the thing came unlabeled, and it is solder flux, $2.08, or $1.56 American, CZB 672-1960. Unfortunately, they seem to have stupid shipping on everything. Now, I'm not sure whether that's just the current political climate, or if just these guys are on vacation, they don't want to sell anything right now, who knows. And that all may be changed by the time you see this, too. So the one that I got specifically is this one, the NC559, 10 cc's of it. No clean solder paste. Solder paste, solder flux, okay. So that looks like it's a little bit more viscous than the one type that I have already. And a little bit less viscous than the other type. So hopefully it'll come in handy. Everybody's always telling me to use more flux on them solder anyway. So here we go. So that's what that is. That's just flux. And I'm going to clean some of that UV glue goop off the outside of it. That's very annoying that stuff leaked in the mail. Anyway, so what is the consistency of this stuff here? Let's poke a toothpick in and see what it's like. Hey, that's fairly solid in there, actually. And wood splinters, perfect. That feels similar to this stuff, actually. That's too bad. I was hoping it would be a little bit looser than that. This stuff here claims to be caster. I got it from China, so I don't know whether it really is or not. Anyway, this is very liquid, like almost as liquid as alcohol or something like that. It's handy. This stuff is handy. I was hoping for something that was kind of halfway between, but this seems to be pretty much the same consistency. Oh well. Never hurts to have more flux around. Let's get onto something that's not messy. At least, hopefully it isn't inside its bag. Looks like an expansion module. Says it's an expansion module. It has a bent potentiometer. It is. Looks like an Arduino shield. Yep. With some kind of messy flux cleanup on the back of it. It is, of course, a Muley function Scheidli. Though I would have probably called it a multifunction shield. So, this is kind of an experimental shield, a good teaching shield kind of thing. For the Uno, it has a couple of sets of shift registers, I think, facing these 7-segment LEDs. It has 4 LEDs there with resistors. It has a buzzer. Is a potentiometer, which is no doubt connected to one of the analog inputs. It has some sockets for a couple of different things. It has 3 push buttons. It has ground plus 5 and A5, digital IO 9, 6, and 5. Those 3 happen to be PWM. You can see the little tilde, wiggly, squiggly beside them. These 4 LEDs are connected to 13, 12, 11, and 10, which are also dimmable, being PWM pins. That says it's supposed to connect to an APC220 Bluetooth voice recognition module. That could be interesting if I had one. Anything interesting on the back other than some messy soldering? What is that messy soldering on? That is on the buzzer. Remove seal after washing. That's why they didn't remove it, because they didn't wash it. Multifunctional expansion board. Shield kit based learning for Arduino Uno R3. Again from CZB672-1960. I paid $3.02, which translates to $2.27 American. Free shipping still on this, which is what I paid for it. So what do we say down here? It looks like it's part of an education package, just sort of a one size fits all. It's got a bunch of different things that you can do without having to plug stuff in if you're just teaching beginners the software stuff. It's got 4 LEDs that we saw. It's got a temperature sensor interface. It's got a different temperature sensor interface. Potentiometer, integrated IR receiver. I didn't see the IR receiver anywhere on it. Oh, price also does not include the integrated receiver and need another shot. All right. Clear as mud. 4 digital tube using 74595, yeah, for winning SPI. 3 separate buttons and a reset button. Buzzer. Bluetooth interface can be used. Yeah, it's got a place to connect that. Servo interface, that's probably what those 3-pin headers were all about. Infrared detection, if you have the thing, yeah. Yeah, if you go searching for the multifunction shield, you can find several of them. It's all the same ones except for this one. You notice it doesn't have the typos on it. And you can find code examples. And here's another place where it was somebody else that was selling them, a little bit more legitimate seller. But they've also got forum posts with links to software, to code examples. And the last thing. 5S15A18V21V lithium ion lithium 18650 packs. That's fairly specific. A wiring harness. A little board here. Says SXT blah 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 5S. So is that in fact a 5S 5 18650s in series, or 5 lithium ion batteries in series battery monitoring? BMS, battery monitoring protection system. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 duplicated sets of transistors and MOSFETs and control chips. What is the chip? Any bets? It is a 10CB. That's not what I was thinking. I was expecting it to be DW01. Okay. A couple of very beefy devices. Looks like a current shunt resistor. And then bunches of transistors, probably MOSFETs, for balancing. Yeah, so these ones are probably for balancing and cell individual cells, and these ones will pass the entire current or cut it off at over voltage or under voltage, I'm guessing. And then we have power minus, battery minus on that side. And I guess the power positive from the source and load just goes straight into the battery pack. And then you have the battery monitoring leads. So basically the ground wire will go to the lowest potential, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will go on the positives of each of the batteries. So most negative, positive of the most negative battery, all the way up, and that one will go positive side of the most positive battery. 5S 15 amp 18 volt 21 volt lithium ion lithium 18650 pack battery cell BMS protection PCB board. I got this one from Best for Cell. I did in fact pay $6.64 Canadian or $4.99 American, free shipping. Yeah, and so there is the wiring diagram. And I managed to guess correctly. Not bad, having never actually played with one of these before. Parameters. Continuous discharge current 15 amps, instantaneous 55. Charging voltage 21 volts. Charging current 5 amps, overcharge 4.2 per cell. Over discharge 2.8 per cell. Okay. So that seems reasonable enough. Does it say anything about balancing? It doesn't. Maybe it doesn't actually balance. I'm not sure. So you may be asking yourself, why do I want that kind of a battery management thing? Well, do you remember this? Yes, it's the free drill that I got curbside last year. It currently is, or was designed as, an 18-volt NiCad pack. And it actually has NiCads in there. But if I put this and 5 18650s in there, not unlike these ones, which I salvaged from a laptop pack at some time in the past, I figure I could make this thing better, actually, because, you know, these are old cells in there and they don't hold a charge very well, and even when they do, they don't have that much oomph in them anymore. So I'm thinking I might do that at some point in the future. What do you think? Am I insane? And there we have today's Mailbag Monday haul, and quite the pile it is. Several multi-packs in here. That was fun. So shipping times, I guess you guys always like to hear about that. Or so I'm told. The battery management board took 26 days. The ceramic screwdrivers and the SMD adapters took 1 month. The wire cutters and the 555s took 3.5 weeks. This little USB flex light took a month. And the multifunction board plus the flux plus the leaky glue pin took 7 weeks to get here. Not too bad, I guess. I like that we're getting closer to 1 month than 2 months shipping time, like it was at the end of last year. That was just brutal. Anyway, questions, comments on this stuff, as always, down in the comments. Thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping me buy this stuff for everybody's entertainment and amusement. And as a reward, I'll show them all the videos a couple of days before the masses get to see them. And for everybody else, thank you for watching. Thanks for coming back. Time and time again, I do appreciate it. I will talk to you later.